the cloud-based data logging on StrideLinx really sets it above the competition. Each router, when activated, will grant the user a 30-day trial of the data logging subscription. And in this video, we'll set up the trial version and create a live monitor and a data report. If you've not already activated your router, please see the videos for the initial setup in the description below. And once you've set up your router, then continue on to this video. Now log on to your StrideLinx account and select the device you want to log data from. Select the Subscriptions tab, and then select the Start Trial button. That is all you really had to do to turn on the data logging option. But before we actually create the data report or the monitor, we must first create the tags that we want to monitor in the router. To do this, select the Services tab, select Add a Service, give it a name, and provide the IP address of the device that we're logging tags from. Now that we have created the device, we must define the service to apply to that device. So select Data Logger. Now we're asked what communication protocol to use. In this video, we'll be using Modbus protocol to communicate with a Brix PLC. For slave, I'm going to select 1. Now that we've created the device and applied the service, we need to edit the device to add the individual tags. Now I'm going to log 2 tags from my Do More Brix PLC that I've already set up in the PLC. Both tags are of 32-bit floating points, and they're mapped to Modbus addresses 400,002 and 400,004. These tags are both temperatures of a water tank, so I will name the first tag as follows. Now with the logger, you'll be able to address coils, discrete inputs, holding registers, and input registers. And since these tags are in the 400,000 range, that means that there are holding registers. And since we're defining that they're holding registers here, all we'll need to do is place the offset address here. As I mentioned before, these are 32-bit floats, and their units will be in Fahrenheit. This gives a suffix for the data display. This portion will allow for scaling in the router. But since I've already set up and scaled these tags in my PLC, all I'll need to do is place a 1 here. For all the other options, I'm going to leave them as the defaults. Then select Add. Now I'll just need to do the same process for my Water Tank 2 tag. That has set up our tags. Now let's verify their status before we continue. Under the Subscription tab, select Here, and then the Data Logger Test Utility. Select Start Test. Now this will quickly test our tags and make sure that we're reading in current values. And everything looks good. With our tag set up, let's create our first data report. Click here, and then select Edit Data Report. Now select Add Data Report. Give it a name, and define your time period. I'm just going to stay with the default of 7 days. Now you can either select black or white background. Once you add it, you'll be given a few options for screen layout. I'm going to select grid so I can show all the different options. This is how I'm going to lay this out. I'm going to place values over here, table in the middle, and then a graph to the right. So I'm going to select value here, give this widget a name, and then select my tank 1 tag. Now I'm going to do the same for down here, but select my second tank. Now in the middle, I'm going to select a table, and then add both tags to it. And since I only need one table in the middle, I'm going to delete the widget holder below. Now to the right, I'll select a graph, add both tags, and then I will also delete the bottom widget here. Now that I have everything set up, I'll select Save, and then View. This gives a pretty good example of all the possibilities you can have here and just how easy it is to set up. One other point while we're here. If you would like a log of your data, go here and select Create CSV. This will allow you to pull the data from the cloud and store locally. I would advise to do this before you turn off any of your data logging. If you do turn off your subscription, you will lose your data. So let's go back and create a live monitor. Go back here and then select Edit Live Monitor. Give this a name, and confirm. Now we'll select 2 rows as I'm just going to display the values here. Apply tank 1 here, and then tank 2 here. Select Save, and now you're viewing live data. This report and monitor can also be seen from your Android or iOS tab. Here I can view right from my Android phone. This is just one of many ways that the StrideLinx can help you be more productive from where you are. If you have any questions about the Stride VPN router, please comment below or contact Automation Direct support team. This video shows many of the support options that we offer. This link will take you to learn more or see more videos on our many products. And if you liked what you've seen, please click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel for upcoming videos. Thanks again for watching.